Hey friends, my name is Catherine. Welcome back to the channel where I talk about all things DeFi. And today I'm gonna show you how to find alpha in real time using one simple tool. Now this tool you've probably seen or used a bunch of times. However, you might be only scratching the surface of what it can do. This tool can be used for so many more things than I even realized just a few months ago. So if you want to find alpha in real time, stay tuned. Now the tool that I'm talking about is Etherscan. It is free, it is the blockchain explorer, and you may have only been using it to, you know, look in your wallet, look in someone else's wallet, but it does so many more things. And even a small amount of knowledge will give you a competitive advantage in this field and allow you to find alpha that you're gonna find on Twitter in 3-4 days by people who are doing this exact thing with Etherscan. So in this video, let me show you how to master it so that you can find out what's popping, what the whales are buying before it goes mainstream. I'll cover what it is, how it works, how to track wallets, how to trace money, how to read smart contracts, how to manually transact with smart contracts if a website goes down. So if you've ever been in a yield farm and the website suddenly goes down, you think you're rugged, there is a manual way to get out of that using Etherscan. So there's so much to this platform that you might not have realized. So stay tuned and let's jump in. And if you like this content, hit that bell button, hit that subscribe button and comment below. All right, let's jump in. All right, so this is Etherscan. Etherscan is a block explorer where you can basically find every transaction that's ever taken place on the Ethereum network. That includes transaction data, wallet addresses, smart contracts, and so much more that I'm gonna show you. So firstly, how does it work? Enter any address into this window and you can find everything that wallet has ever done. So let's just look up Vitalik. So Vitalik Buterin, the creator of Ethereum. If we go to their ENS domain, I've showed you in another video how to create an ENS. It's basically an easy way to find your wallet. So you'll see here that he has 20 million in here of Ethereum and then all of these different ERC20 tokens. Now, I'll walk you through how each of the parts of Etherscan work, starting with here. So you can see here that the balance is 6,707 Ethereum. And then every other token that is not Ethereum shows in this drop-down menu. So if you are in your wallet, this is the single source of truth. So it doesn't matter what your MetaMask says, because oftentimes when we trade tokens, they don't automatically show up in our MetaMask until we add them. So if you're wondering what's in your wallet, the best place to go is Etherscan. Now, when you come into Etherscan, let's look at this ENS. You can find out when you traded this specific token. So you can see here that 126 days ago, he claimed his ENS tokens when there was an airdrop. So he didn't actually trade them. He just had them airdropped. And if you look into the transaction hash, you can see this is the sort of receipt number for this exact transaction. You can see what block it was done, when it was done from his wallet address. So if this was your wallet address would be here. This is the contract, so this is the ENS token contract, and the value in Ethereum. So if you're not trading Ethereum specifically, it won't show you the value. This is just if you were sort of swapping into Ethereum. The transaction fee, so it's $26. This was the gas price at the time, and the Ether price was almost $4,000 at the time. So that's everything that you'll see on a transaction. And when you look into the contract, this is the ENS contract data. So if we come in here, this looks a little different than a wallet address. So I'll jump back. When we're in someone's wallet, so if we go back to Vitalik's wallet, you can see here there's different sections. This is the transactions. This is basically every single transaction that's ever taken place on this wallet. You can see there's two pending. The gas must have been set super low for this because it's taking so long. And you can actually filter by different types of transactions. So these are transfers in to this. So this is actually different wallets sending items to Vitalik's wallet, which because his wallet's one of the most famous wallets there is, he also gets a lot of transfers in. So the transactions is all of the transactions on the wallet, the internal Texans. These are essentially smart contracts that are triggered by these external transactions. I don't really pay attention to these. ERC20 tokens, so these are essentially all of the ERC20 transactions in one spot. So you can see, like right here, transactions being sent in of this specific token. So this looks like a Victoria's Secret token, but you can find all of the ERC20 tokens that are in here. There will be some transactions connected to those in this ERC20 tab. ERC721, these are NFTs. So every NFT that is in this wallet, which if you scroll down to the bottom, obviously this Salik is a ton of regular coins. So if we come up here, you can see that there's ERC721 tokens, and these are NFTs that are in the wallet. And when you click on here, you can actually see when these ERC721 tokens were sent in or out of this wallet. These are for bundle transactions. I don't really pay attention to this. Analytics. So this is showing the analytics of the specific wallet. So from the highest Ethereum balance it's ever had to the lowest, to the highest USD value, to the lowest. You can see again transactions, so when this is super active, transaction fees. So you can see here that they've paid, or Vitalik's paid almost 21 Ethereum on fees. So that is 62,000 at current prices. ETH transfers, so when you're sending ETH from one wallet to another, and then other token transfers. So you can see like activity, and since January 2022, there's been a lot of token transfers from this wallet. So that is how you essentially dig through a wallet and find out what's going on. Next, we have wallet tracing. So if you followed my Wonderland video, this guy on Twitter is famous for being an on-chain sleuth, as he calls himself. He will basically trace wallets. Because everything's on the public blockchain, it's really easy to see where money comes from, where money goes. And then he creates maps like this, where he is tracking when money comes from one contract, one wallet to another wallet, and then back to something like Coinbase or Binance to be able to cash out. So here, you're seeing him basically break down an NFT mint that happened, where they collected 3.7 million, then they sent it back to different Binance wallets. So within Etherscan, you can track everything. So every single transaction is public, which means, you know, if I click on this random wallet, I can see everything that's ever been in contact with this wallet. So if I am launching an NFT project and I have to, you know, add liquidity to it, or, you know, post the smart contract, that is going to be attached to a wallet, which will need to be funded somehow. And that's how you trace wallets, basically through a public network like Etherscan. Now let's look at smart contracts. So if I go into Convex Finance, you can see here that this is a token. So it's not a wallet, it's a token. And the contract is here. And if we look at the different tabs, which I showed you earlier, now when you're on a token contract on Etherscan, it looks different than when you're on a wallet. So if we look here, you can see that there's a contract with a little tick mark. That means it's been verified, and you can look through the contract source code. So if you know Solidity and you want to invest in a project and you want to make sure that it's legit and there's no rugs in there or anything, you know, that could steal your money, and you knew how to look through this, you can actually look through it within Etherscan. So you can read through everything. You can also read specific parts of the contract, and then you can also write specifically to the contract. So you can connect your wallet to MetaMask. And let's say, for example, I want to do something with Convex Finance and the website went down, but I needed to withdraw my money or approve something. I could do that directly to the contract without having to have the website be up. So if you've ever been in a yield farm and the website's gone down, you don't know how to take out your liquidity pool, this is how you would do it. You would connect your wallet to Etherscan or whatever blockchain explorer you're using. So there's different ones on different chains. And then you would be able to specifically work with that contract to be able to take out your funds or approve them or whatever else you needed to do. Now let me show you something else that's pretty cool with smart contracts and Etherscan, is if you take out the IO and add DETH.NAT, it will open a Visual Studio with all of the contracts in here. So you can, if you work better this way, or if you want to fork the code, you could do so by just adding DETH.NAT into your address bar. Now, if you want to find out the Etherscan code for a certain token, you could go on to CoinGecko and find it. So let's just say I wanted to find CVX, and I could just click on Etherscan, it will bring me to the official contract. I always suggest that if you don't know for sure about a coin. When I type convex in here, you'll see that it comes up, but you'll also see a bunch of other random addresses on here. Now, convex has been around for a bit, it's verified. However, sometimes you get spam or scam addresses, so you really want to make sure you check in CoinGecko what it is you're looking for. Now, once you come in here, this convex token, so this is another part of Etherscan, which looks different again from the wallet address and from the smart contract address, where you can see the holders. So if we go on here, it'll show you the max supply for this token. It'll show you how many holders it has, how many transfers there's been. And when you come in here, you can actually see the top 1,000 holders of this coin and where it is that they're sitting. You can see the volume, so how much volume has this coin done in the last 24 hours. You can also see the decentralized exchanges, so what are people buying and selling. You can see there was a sale here 2 minutes ago for 14.5 convex. You can read the contract data. You can see the analytics. So you can check price, you know, transfer amount, transfer account, unique receivers. So basically put any address in here and you can see the activity over that time. Same thing with the historical price. Another cool thing is up here, if you look at a chart, you can see, you know, how the price is looking zoomed out, you know, what the trades have been in the last 1 minute. So Etherscan is, you know, there's so much to it that oftentimes we don't even know what we don't know because we haven't sat down to explore it. So there's a ton of different charts and trackers on Etherscan, so you can make sure that you're finding stuff. Now, another interesting thing, and I'm going to show you before I finish up, is if we come into the homepage and you want to just look around and see what's happening, you can look up ERC20 top tokens. So you can see over the last 24 hours, what's doing the most volume, what's changed in price so much. So if you got into Kova yesterday, you would have seen a 2,352% increase. The volume is super low. So you can also filter it by, okay, what's changed in price, what's launched, what's starting to do more volume. Same with NFTs. So if we click on 721, I'm going to guess that we're going to see the moonbirds or whatever they are that have just taken over the last day or so. Okay, so NFTs over the last 24 hours. So ENS, that's up there. If we come in here, we can also look at what projects or protocols are using the most gas. So when we're, you know, just tracking gas, if you click on here, it'll show you what are the top gas guzzlers. So OpenSea is using 12.1% of all Ethereum over the last 3 hours. Over the last 24 hours is 12.6. So OpenSea is basically taking over most of Ethereum. And then the second to that is Uniswap. And if you click down here, what you'll sometimes find is if there's a new project, so let's just say this thing, VFriends, right? So if you didn't know that this was launching and you were paying attention to gas, you could find this without needing anyone to tell you about it. You could see that this thing is launching and it's using up Ethereum gas, and you could jump on that quickly to find out what this is about. Same thing as, like, what is this random contract that's has a ton of different things pending. That is how you find projects early, by seeing, like, what is using the most gas. So again, on Ethereum, because the Ethereum gas is so expensive, this is a good way to find projects as they launch. Now, one last thing I will show you is sometimes when you are, you know, trading, you're buying a lot of stuff, you want to know, okay, how much did I buy this token for? So if you go into your address, I just clicked on this random address as you saw from the homepage, and I want to know, okay, when did I get this SOS token? And you can see that I claimed it 117 days ago. And if I look at the transaction on the day of the transfer, this was worth almost $70. Now it's worth $12. So if I'm trying to do my taxes or something, technically I should be paying on the $70 because that was the value when it came in. But that is how you find out how much, first of all, when you got a token, how much it was valued at then versus how much it is now, so that you can know, like, your cost for tokens to be able to track this stuff from your wallet if you're not tracking as you do the trades.
And that is it. That is how to use Etherscan. Again, you're only watching videos, so you're only going to learn so much. The best thing I would recommend is to jump in there and start playing around with it yourself. So if you've only gone on there to track your own wallet, start looking around, start looking at other wallets, tokens, smart contracts, and you'll become much more familiar with the whole interface. Now, if you want to know other tools that I use for DeFi, check out my DeFi tools video where I walk you through all the different websites I use, dApps that I use in order to track revenue, protocols, what are new projects, chain analytics, everything like that. And if you want to know how to set up an ENS domain, I have a video on that too. Anyway, hope you like this. Subscribe to my channel, and I will see you on the next DeFi video.